Hello and welcome to the second part of the unit Elements of a PIM Fuel Cell, where we will explain in detail the electrodes of the fuel cell and the bipolar plates. Now we will discuss about other fundamental part of the PIM fuel cell, the electrodes. On both sides of the membrane we find the electrodes which are responsible for collecting the electron resulting from the dissociation of hydrogen molecule at the anode, and bring the electrons to the union of the electrode with the cathode to form the water molecule. Both electrodes must be distributed over the entire surface of the membrane in order to allow the collection of electrons throughout the membrane. The reaction gases must be able to reach the interfaces between the electrode, the membrane and the catalyst, and therefore they must be porous. We can see this characteristic of the electrodes in the figure, where it is appreciated how the porous material allows the passage of the different reaction compounds. Additionally, the catalyst must be right between the electrodes and the membrane, so that when the hydrogen molecule arrives at the catalyst, the electrons leave on one side and the protons on the other. For this reason, another function of the electrodes is to support the catalyst. In fact, the catalyst is on the surface on the carbon particle Xc72 cabot. In this way, with less quantity of catalyst, the same contact surface with gases is achieved. Since the carbon electrodes are made of carbon, it is easier for the carbon particles with the catalyst to adhere to them. We can see this behavior in the figure that zooms in the carbon particles with the catalyst. Finally, in the image at the top right, we can see an image of the microscope where it can be seen the catalyst around the carbon particles next to the membrane. Both the electrodes and the membrane are arranged in such a way that they form a perfect assembly. As already mentioned, the assembly is called membrane electrode assembly, or MEA, and it is done with a compression at a temperature of 140 degrees Celsius. The electrodes can be either carbon paper or carbon fabric. The first ones offer a much lower thickness of the membrane electrode assembly. However, the second one allows a higher absorption of water and a better contact with the bipolar plate. This puts this cell in contact with the next one. Besides that, the carbon particles with the catalyst are arranged on the surface of the electrode that will be in contact with the membrane either by painting it or by spraying it. Before mounting the membrane on the membrane electrode assembly, it must be activated by keeping it in water with 3% hydrogen peroxide for 1 hour. Then it needs to be boiled for 1 hour in sulfuric acid. Finally, it is cleaned in deionized water. In this picture, we can appreciate the appearance of a single cell with the membrane electrode assembly mounted and the Nafion membrane between the two carbon fabric electrodes. The images on the right correspond to the membrane electrode assembly or a speck membrane in the same single cell. Let's now introduce the concept of bipolar plates. Each cell in a fuel cell requires channels that allow the reaction gases to be distributed evenly throughout the cell. In addition, it also requires that the water formed at the cathode can be evacuated from the interior of the cell. When building fuel cells, the cells are usually arranged in series so that the current is determined by the area of the cell and the voltage is determined by the number of cells arranged in series. The simplest assembly would be to connect the element that allows the gas to be channeled into the cell, and which is also conductive, of the cathode with the anode of the next cell, as shown above on the right. We can observe that oxygen is supplied by the cathode and hydrogen by the anode. The simple way to form a compact stack is shown in the figure below. The pieces that allow the gas to be channeled from one side to the other are cast in one piece and therefore called bipolar plates, because the same piece is the positive in one cell and the negative in the next one. The bipolar plates also have two other functions. Firstly, they serve as a mechanical support for the membrane electrode assembly and guarantee the tightness of each cell, preventing the reaction gases from mixing. Secondly, they must allow the cell to be cool to ensure that the operating temperature does not exceed 80 degrees Celsius. The image below illustrates the concept. However, it is not the best solution in terms of homogeneous distribution of reaction gases or water extraction. In the next slide, we will see why. Here, the figure shows different configuration of the channel that allows the distribution of the gases through the bipolar plates. The first three channel arrangements present the same problem. In the first one, if one of the channels is flooded, this channel is not used to receive reaction gases, so the gas is distributed through the rest of the channels. The same problem occurs in number two, which is the variant of the first one but with gas feeding through only one channel. The increase in the flow of the reaction gases does not succeed in eliminating the water, because if it is opposed to the passage in a channel, the gas will be distributed over the rest without dragging the water. The third configuration allows the gases to be better distributed throughout the membrane in case any part of the channel becomes blocked by water. However, it doesn't solve the problem of water extraction. Therefore, in these three cases, the active surface of the membrane is lost and the current density is reduced. In order to avoid this problem, the serpentine settings from 4 to 8 can be used. In this configuration, the gases flow through a single channel that runs over the entire surface of the membrane. If there is an increase in water in the channel, the water is dragged out all the way, as the gases have no other way to circulate and post it. Configuration 4 is suitable for small areas and configuration 5 for larger areas. The latter has the problem that one of the channels can be blocked. Configuration 6 can solve the blockage, although it doesn't allow the water to be removed from the flooded area, and we have the same problem as in the first configurations. If the surface area is very large, as in the case of fuel cells in hydrogen vehicles, the normal serpentine configuration could cause the pressure difference between one channel and another to be very large. This happens as a result of the long travel of the channel and the gas to be transferred from one channel to another without completing the travel. In order to solve this problem, the double coil configuration 7 or the mirror coil configuration 8 can be used, which requires several gas inlets and outlets. The last two options allow water to be drawn not only from the distribution channels, but also from the electrodes, preventing them flooding. Between the gas inlet and the next channel of the configuration 9, there is no communication through the bipolar plate. Therefore, the gas has no other way to continue than underneath the bipolar plate, through the electrode and dragging the water it has produced. It is clear that the main problem with this configuration is the increase in pressure required from the system in order to overcome the pressure losses encountered by the gases to pass through the electrodes. In the case of configuration 10, the concept is the same, but the channels are distributed according to a fractal variation. Bipolar plates must be corrosion resistant to be able to contact with the acid in the electrolyte in a hot and humid environment. They must also be impermeable to the passage of gases and must have very good electrical conductivity. They should be as thin as possible, as light as possible, and have low cost. Currently, there are not many materials that can meet all these requirements. One of which is graphite. The construction of the channels can be done in different ways, shown in the slide. The first of these is the machining of pure graphite sheet. It is a slow and expensive process where the material is brittle and can be broken during stack assembly. The material must be of sufficient thickness to be cast-tight. If the graphite is mixed with a polymer, the plate can be made using the injection molding technique, although in this case the conductivity is worse than that of pure graphite. Finally, a mixed solution is to use a mixture of polymer and graphite with a higher percentage of graphite. This allows to increase the conductivity and the plate to be made by compression with temperature until the crystalline transition of the polymer is achieved. The process is slower than the previous one, but it improves the conductivity. In the image on the top, we can see different examples of bipolar plates with a serpentine distribution. It can be seen where the gas supply and the outlet channels are located, which in turn become the gas inlet of the next cell. The construction of the bipolar metal plate has obvious advantages. For example, that the metal is much better conductor than graphite, and it also allows a better extraction of heat. They can also be constructed by machining the parts without the danger of breakage during the manufacture or assembly process in the stack. In addition, because they are not porous, they can be extremely thin. Moreover, the reaction gas ducts on one side of the bipolar plate can be the negative side of the cooling gas ducts, due to the high conductivity of the metal. This reduces the contact section between one side of the plate and the other. We can see this in the figure on the right. In this way, the fuel cell can be cooled without the need to use reaction gases with values above the required stoichiometry. However, metals have some problems. One of them is its high density, which makes the weight of each plate greater than its graphite equivalent. Besides that, metals react very well with oxygen in a hot, humid, acidic environment. Therefore, they must be built in stainless steel, which is much more difficult to machine and weld. In the image, we can see the bipolar plates, metal plates of the hydrogen vehicle prototype presented by BMW at the World Hydrogen Energy Conference in 2016. The distribution is with multiple coils. On the right, we can see the bipolar plate membrane electrode assembly, bipolar plate construction, and on the side of each assembly are the ducts for the reaction gases and for the cooling of the cells. With this, we conclude this unit about the different elements of a PEM fuel cell. Thank you very much for your attention.